Hi everyone. Today let's look at the three most realistic Vietnam War movies. Number three is We Were Soldiers. It aims to accurately depict a major battle in the Vietnam War without delving much into the politics. Mel Gibson is excellent as US Lieutenant Colonel Hal Moore. In his memoir, We Were Soldiers Once and Young, Hal Moore complained, "Every damn Hollywood movie got the Vietnam War wrong." We Were Soldiers director Randall Wallace said he was inspired by that comment and was determined to get it right this time. The movie is based on the Battle of Ia Drung in 1965, which was the first major battle between the US and the North Vietnamese. The movie gets bonus points for opening with a Vietnamese ambush on French troops in 1954. The Vietnamese ambush leader tells his men, "Kill all they send and they will stop coming." You can't understand the Second Indochina War, aka the Vietnam War, aka the American War, unless you understand the First Indochina War, in which the Vietnamese defeated the French in 1954. Some critics felt that We Were Soldiers wasn't anti-war enough. I disagree. It's a realistic depiction of war, and war is hell. For me, a realistic war movie is by necessity an anti-war movie. I give this one 7 out of 10. Number 2 is Danger Close, The Battle of Long Tan. It's an Australian movie about Australia's biggest battle of the Vietnam War, which occurred in 1966, southeast of Saigon. The Australians were greatly outnumbered, but they had air support, artillery support, and much better equipment and training. Danger close is a military term for friendly fire that is dangerously close to your own troops. Danger close artillery fire is sometimes used as a last resort when a defensive line is about to be overrun. This film is one for the military history enthusiasts. If you're interested in equipment, tactics, and logistics, from artillery ranging to helicopter ammo drops, then this is the movie for you. Just like We Were Soldiers, some critics didn't like the fact that the movie had little to say about the morality of Australia's involvement in the war. But that isn't what the film is trying to do. It was made in 2019. At this point, almost everyone agrees that the Vietnam War was a tragic mistake. And that is the government's fault. It's not the fault of the brave Australian soldiers who did their job for their mates beside them. Danger Close aims to be a realistic portrayal of one of the most significant battles in Australian military history, and it does a great job. I give it 8 out of 10. Number 1 is First They Killed My Father. This movie really changed my view of its director Angelina Jolie. It's based on the memoir of the same name by Luong Ung, who co-wrote the screenplay with Jolie. It begins in 1975 in Cambodia, when Ung was 7 years old. That year, Pol Pot's Khmer Rouge defeated the Cambodian government in the Cambodian Civil War. The Khmer Rouge murdered most of Ung's family and forced her to become a child soldier. The Khmer Rouge's victory was a direct result of the war in neighbouring Vietnam. Neither side in the Vietnam War respected the Cambodian border, so the Cambodian story is absolutely part of the Vietnam War story. During the Vietnam War, the North Vietnamese used neutral Cambodia as a sanctuary and as part of the Ho Chi Minh Trail that transported soldiers, weapons and supplies into South Vietnam. Between 1965 and 1973, the US dropped 2.7 million tons of bombs on rural Cambodia, more than they dropped in all of World War II. This US bombing destabilized the country and increased support for the Khmer Rouge. The North Vietnamese also greatly assisted the Khmer Rouge until 1978, when the Khmer Rouge invaded Vietnam and were quickly defeated by the far superior Vietnamese military. First They Killed My Father is an experiential movie, told from the perspective of a 7-year-old who is not old enough to understand why these horrific things are happening. She is simply trying to survive and find her family. Jolie filmed the movie in Cambodia with a Cambodian cast of first-time actors in the local Khmer language. The children fleeing through a battle between the Vietnamese and the Khmer Rouge is stunningly shot, and the scene of scared children running through a field of landmines is heartbreaking. First-time child actress Shrey Shrytuk Sayum's performance as Ung is brilliant and haunting. This movie is another reminder of the enormity of the crimes that the US government was directly and indirectly responsible for in Indochina. If your heart is still in one piece, then this movie will break it. For me, it's a masterpiece, 10 out of 10. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.